Video, we'll be explaining the fundamentals of SRT. SRT stands for single rope technique. In single rope technique, you'll be ascending and descending on a single rope. In most caves, you'll anchor your rope at the top of a pit or a rappel. You'll rappel down in, check out the cave, then you'll attach your equipment to your rope and ascend back out. There's many different styles and methods for ascending and descending in caves. Today's video, we're going to be focusing on using a rappel rack to descend and using the frog technique to ascend. All right, let's talk about the equipment that we're going to use in single rope technique. Probably the most important piece of equipment that we'll be using is the harness. In caving, the harnesses don't normally have a lot of padding and are normally pretty lightweight and compact, because you have to be able to stick them in a bag to carry around with you in the cave. So this is a standard caving harness. Notice that there's really no padding back here, really lightweight, can pack down really far. The normal attachment point is a locking D carabiner here. And when you put this on, you're gonna want everything to be very tight. It also has some attachment points here so you can add your carabiners. The next piece of equipment that you will need is a chest harness. You'll have to hold some of the equipment up in the air. So there's lots of different styles of chest harnesses that you can buy or make yourself. This one has several places that you can adjust the chest harness to make maximum comfort, but then also to get it really tight, because you're going to want it to be really tight to your chest when you're actually climbing. When you're normally standing like this, the equipment doesn't have to be all that tight. But when you're hunched all down like this and you're attached to a rope, you're gonna want everything to be really tight. So this has two adjustment points right here and one adjustment point right here. It also is designed to keep the webbing away from your neck, because it can cut into your neck sometimes or really crush your chest if you pull it in really tight. The next piece of equipment is the rappel rack. And what I have here is a micro rack. The biggest advantage to the micro rack is that it is lightweight and compact. Now, the way the rappel rack works is with these bars, the rope goes around the bars, and you can push the bars closer together. It compacts the rope, adds more friction, and it slows you down. A huge advantage of a rappel rack over a standard figure eight is a figure eight will put twists and turns in the rope as you go down, whereas a rappel rack will not. Now, it's very important that you put the rappel rack on correctly, because if you don't, all the bars will pop open and you'll be free falling to the bottom of the pit. To put the rappel rack on the rope properly, we're going to push a piece of rope through and then put the bar on. Now, if we had done this backwards, when we put pressure on it, the bar would simply pop open and the rope would come out. Let me show you an example of that. Come in from the other side. Oh, look, I've got it correct now. Oops, I'm free falling. That's bad. So, push the rope pieces through, put the bar in place, slide the next bar up, push the piece of rope through, put the bar in place. And the way the hyper bar works is you just simply loop it over the top, and then as you pull down, notice that the rope is really constricted here. We'll probably not move very much at all with the rope being this constricted. To go faster, you can simply give it a lot of room there, and the bars will open up. The standard way to control the rappel rack is with a glove. Once you have your glove on, you can hold the rope, you can hold the bars, and move the bars up and down as you like. And the rappel rack simply gets added with a carabiner to the D-ring of the harness. The next few pieces of equipment that we'll be talking about are the ascenders. There are three ascenders that we'll be using, and the way the ascenders work are pretty easy. They attach to the rope, and they have little teeth in them so that as you push it up, it's really easy, but then it won't slide back down. Push it up, it won't slide back down. This rope is called kern mantle rope because it has a kern on the inside and a mantle on the outside. The little teeth that dig in are not nearly long enough to get to the actual kern. It just stays at the mantle level and it doesn't really damage the rope very much at all. We'll be using three ascenders. This is the right-handed ascender. This is the left-handed ascender, which I'll be using as a quick attachment safety for my left hand. And the third ascender is a Petzl crawl that I'll add to my harness and will be held up with my chest harness to keep me up and to slide up the rope as I go up the rope. One common practice in caving and single rope technique is to always be wearing all of your equipment so that you can change from ascend to descend or from descend to ascend at a moment's notice. You never know when something's going to happen in a cave. For instance, you could get your glove stuck in your rappel rack. If you had all of your ascension equipment in your bag, you would have to take all that out in order to ascend just enough to get your glove out of your rappel rack to continue rappelling. That's why it's important to be wearing all of your equipment at all times so that you can easily do what's called a changeover. Now, normally, the changeover that you'll need to do if you're going to climb a tree and then rappel back down would be your have your ascension equipment on, you send up to the top, you change over to descend, and then you rappel down to the ground. That's what I'm going to demonstrate for you right now. So let's say I ascend a few more feet and I'm ready to do a changeover. The first thing that we're going to want to do is add our quick attachment safety onto the rope, because during this process we want to make sure we always have two safeties on the rope in case one of them breaks. All right, the first thing we'll do is take the rope out from between our feet and move it to our right side. The next step is to take your rappel rack and attach it to the rope. Attach the carabiner of the rappel rack to your D-ring and lock the carabiner. At this point, it'd be really helpful if you took out as much of the slack out of the rappel rack as you can. And then we want to lock the rappel rack off. Now for this particular rappel rack, it means we're going to go over the top, around it, and back over the top. Next, we can stand up in our feet and take our crawl off. Then we should be able to sit down and have all of our weight on the rappel rack. Now notice that, let's see here, let me bring my safety down. Notice that at this point my crawl is not tight, my safety is not tight, and my right-handed ascender is not tight, which means that all of my weight is on top of the rappel rack that is locked off. At this point I can take my other ascenders off, leaving the quick attachment safety to last. Attach everything to this my harness. Get my glove ready for rappelling. And then the last step is to take off my quick attachment safety. I can unlock my rappel rack and descend to the ground.